Francis Elliot Bonfo. And you've not seen, no, you've seen him when we're doing the video on the library. He's Gideon. So he's one of my teachers. Today is 29. And then we are obeying what the government or the president is saying. He's saying that all the final year students should go back to school. And since we are teachers in the final year classes, which is the junior high, we came to school today to introduce the kids to the classroom. And then also, you know, we spoke to them about what Corona is about. And then we have some nurses also coming in to check their temperature and then ask some few questions. I am happy today. Do you know why? Because our building has started. We made a video last 3 days where he was part of it. We're talking about the process, you know, wherever we've gotten to and all that. So today, 29th, we came to school and the boys have started the concrete. I don't want to go much into when it comes to the building thing because he has more in-depth knowledge about it. So what are they doing now, Mr. Bonfo?
Right now they are laying the concrete for the foundation. So they are filling the foundation track that they did. So they are filling in the concrete for the foundation before they place the blocks, which is called footing.
Okay.
So that's what they're doing.
Okay. So he's the project manager for this library, and then he's the supervisor, like the borough. I am very happy that we are doing this, and then the stage we have gotten to. Now, like he said, we are doing the concrete where we are mixing stones and then cement and then sand. This is the most difficult part and this is the most expensive part. Why do you think this is the most expensive part when it comes to building the concrete side? What makes it expensive? You can take it off. I'll just stay back. Yes, so you understand.
This is the most expensive part, as my head says. Simply because if the building will be very strong and last for long, it depends on the foundation. So, mixing of the concrete, if they take about 2 barrels of sand, you need to add about 1 bag of cement so that it will be very rich so that, to support everything that will build on it. That is why it's the most expensive.
Yeah, I don't know how you build in Brazil or in the Caribbean or in the diaspora. I don't know how you build. Most of you talk to us about they say something called earth bag. Do you know anything about it? You know,
they fill
sack.
Sack, yeah. With some materials. I don't know what material.
I think clay or sand.
Yeah, I mean, they use it to fill the. Some of them use it with for. I don't know the name. They build, they put wood.
Okay.
Board together, and then they put, let's say, a plywood here.
Okay.
We use plywood for that. Then they put one. Then that space in between. Mm-hmm. They fill
those things. Okay.
Instead
okay.
of doing it different. The blocks and all that.
Okay. So you think that one is less expensive?
Very less expensive.
Yeah. But it looks like we are not used to it. Because even the government is trying to introduce bricks.
Yeah,
building
yeah.
with bricks, but still Ghanaians, we like this one. Yeah, so like I was asking, how do you build from wherever you are? Do you also have to dig the foundation, put in concrete before you start the footing, which is where you put the blocks and then you start laying the blocks and all that? So the other issue is that with the support that we need from you, we take it step by step. Okay, the first support that came in, this is what it has gotten us. Okay, so using GoFundMe and then some of you sending it to me directly, this is what we have done so far. So after today, when they are done with the concrete, then they will start the footing, which is they will start using the blocks, and we have some blocks over here. So when you go on GoFundMe, you will realize that the amount has been increased. This is the reason why. We can't really budget. We can put a budget to it. But here, this is how things happen. You can go buy cement today for 38 Ghana cedi. The next day or the next 2 days, you go and it's 39 or 40. So you can't really put a price to an item. That is why we feel like we should rather do it as and when the donation comes. So if today somebody donates maybe $50. Then we'll go and buy a bag of cement and put it down. Because if we say that we're going to wait till the money is up or we get the bulk money, we will go there and then we'll come back and then we'll come back asking for more. And that is not what we want to do. So basically this video is just to tell you that today is 29th and this time we are in an official outfit. Yeah. Mostly you see me in my Ekow Simpson t-shirt, but this time we are in school, official thing, so we have to look more official. This is our outfit. I know you saw two of the teachers wearing this. When it comes to my school, we have decided to go uniform on Wednesday. So on Wednesdays they put on this kind of outfit. Yeah, but today, and I mean on Monday, Tuesday, you can put on anything that you like, but on Wednesday you put on this, your traditional outfit. This is more of the reason why we say that let's promote Africa. We are promoting what we are patronizing what we make here in Africa. I know this one will look more European, more foreign. Look at him. But then once in a while we need to put on our kind of clothes to send the message out there. Alright, so thank you very much for checking us out. Today we brought you two news. One is the children coming to school, the final yesterday coming to school. And then two, the concrete session has started. So now when we come to you for donation, it means that we are going to cast or we are going to mold more cement blocks to raise the building. Mr. Bong.
So like I said the other time, keep on bringing in that support. We really need it. Since you started with us, we want you to help us complete it. So keep on.
Didn't feed the workers.
How later we talk. Alright, so that is Atul, the one in charge of the building. So I came here today. Today is 29. The government says we should come to school. So when I came, I realized that they are still on the project. As you can see, they are now filling the diggings with concrete. And now this is concrete. So hey, I just want to tell everybody that you guys are doing amazing, supporting this whole project. That is my school over there. Yes, and that the teacher's quarters. All right, so we've started and then we on it. As you can see, the concrete is up there and then very soon they will start putting the blocks on it, which they call
is that what friend that what the blocks do to that one? Floating was happening
after that. Footings, yes. So then after that they will do the